Hi, it's Katrina. From sunken treasures worth billions to haunted caves full of strange skulls, here are eight incredible underwater discoveries. Number 8. Bizarre Cenote Skeletons. The cenotes of Mexico are a huge draw for tourists who like to scuba dive and experience another world. But one flooded sinkhole in southern Mexico has terrified local villagers so much that they refuse to visit, and for good reason. Underwater archaeologists recently found a submerged cavern that was littered with elongated skulls and human bones. Known as Sacsayhuamán, the cenote is located in Mexico's Yucatán Peninsula and was sometimes used by the ancient Maya as a place for sacrificial offerings. The eerie cenote sits just outside the ruins of the ancient Maya city of Mayapan. Mayapan was once a political center from the 12th to the 15th century AD. The city was enclosed within a stone wall, where the cenotes acted as a vital source of water for the 17,000 residents who lived there. But over time, local legends were whispered about Sacsayhuamán, including the fact that it was guarded by a feathered horse-headed serpent that perched in the tree before spinning around in the air and taking a diving leap into the water. For 2 weeks in 2014, curious archaeologists dove into the cenote to explore. It appeared something sinister took place inside, and perhaps knowledge of this was passed down over the years, leading to the development of legends and myths. On the first day, they discovered two chambers in the cavern connected by a tunnel, with bones scattered across the floor. The team identified 10 skulls in the first chamber and 5 in the second, and they think they'll find even more. If that wasn't strange enough, these weren't normal skulls either. The skulls were elongated, intentionally flattened during infancy. With no marks to indicate any exact causes of death, researchers believe the people who were buried there probably weren't actually sacrificed. And with few artifacts located, scientists aren't sure whether the people were elite or if they received any kind of special treatment. Belonging to both males and females, ranging from teenagers to adults, questions still remain about the reason why the bodies were there in the first place. The fact that the cenote lies to the south of Mayapan, the direction associated with the underworld, makes researchers believe the dead may have been buried there to await their next cycle of creation. Back then, the ancient Mayans would have wanted to avoid burying people near the rest of the population, and they certainly wouldn't have wanted to drink the water there either, which is why the cenotes may have been excluded from the boundaries drawn on original maps of the city. Either way, these strange elongated skulls make for a chilling, if not interesting, discovery. Number 7. The San Jose Galleon. In 1708, off the coast of Cartagena, Colombia, a large ship full of treasure was on its way back to Spain when disaster struck. The San Jose Galleon was attacked by British forces lying in wait at the port to steal the treasure. As the captain pushed forward, the British Navy tried to board the galleon 3 different times to take it as their own, but the ship then burst into flames. It sank to the bottom of the sea, along with the 600 people and $20 billion worth of gold, silver, and jewels that were on board. Since then, the San Jose has been lying on the ocean floor, lost for centuries. In 2015, the Colombian government announced that they had found the San Jose, but instead of being a celebrated find, it became the center of an international custody dispute, with many wanting a piece of the pie. A robotic submarine called the Remus 6000, which is operated by the US-based Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution, officially discovered the ship. The nearly 13-foot-long underwater autonomous vehicle can explore up to 3.7 miles below the sea's surface. It was able to descend just 30 feet above the San Jose to snap photographs of the galleon, as well as its bronze, dolphin-engraved cannons, which researchers used to distinguish it was indeed the San Jose. The original salvage company stated they found the ship in the early 1980s, but kept it quiet. Former Colombian President Juan Manuel Santos announced that the Colombian Navy had actually found the galleon in 2015. Spain says that it doesn't matter. The billions belong to the Spanish crown. As experts and historians battle over this sunken treasure, the ship, which had been submerged for 300 years, continues to rest on the seafloor with its riches up for grabs. The exact location of the holy grail of shipwrecks has been kept private to stop divers and treasure seekers from looting the treasure. Number 6. Underwater City of Xicheng. Xicheng is often called the Atlantis of the East. The small underwater city of Xicheng is a gorgeous and mysterious time capsule of Imperial China. Perfectly preserved 131 feet under Qiandao Lake in Zhejiang Province stands the magnificent stone architecture from the Ming and Qing dynasties. The submerged city of Xicheng is so majestic, the underwater complex is also known as Lion City in Mandarin. It was purposely flooded in 1959 to make way for a dam and the hydroelectric power station. About 300,000 residents were relocated for the project, some of whom had families that had lived in the city for hundreds of years. But they didn't have a choice. The city was flooded and forgotten. In 2001, the city was rediscovered when the Chinese government organized an expedition with professional divers to see what remained of the lost metropolis. Exploration and interest increased even further about 10 years later, when the magazine Chinese National Geography published illustrations of what the city might have looked like in its glory days. Despite being completely submerged underwater, Xicheng has remained astonishingly well-preserved. The city has been protected from wind, rain, and sun erosion. Underwater photographs revealed the city had 5 entrance gates instead of the traditional 4. There were 265 archways on the city streets featuring carved stonework of dragons, phoenixes, lions, and historical inscriptions. Originally, China was going to send submarine tours to the city for the general public, but plans were scrapped due to fears that tours would damage the historic buildings there. There's still a lot to explore and map out, so today, only advanced divers with lots of experience can get up close to the ruins. Number 5. Atlit Yam Skeleton. Off the coast of Israel, a submerged prehistoric settlement known as Atlit Yam has been drawing the attention of researchers for decades. It lies 26 to 40 feet below sea level. A marine archaeologist named Ehud Galili first discovered the site in 1984, and ever since then, underwater excavations have revealed a trove of fascinating discoveries. The ruins have been incredibly well preserved by the sand, dating all the way back to 7000 BC. As researchers set out to locate, excavate, and salvage the prehistoric settlements, they found 17 submerged sites, including 13 Neolithic sites near the shore. 7 megaliths that weighed about 1,320 pounds each are arranged in a stone semicircle in the center of everything. Obvious cut marks carved into the stones, arranged around the freshwater spring, suggest that they may have been used for a water ritual. A stone well excavated at the site was found to contain animal bones, stone, flint, wood, bone artifacts, and human remains, suggesting it was not only a water well, but a disposal pit. Archaeologists found actual skeletons under the water, which is extremely rare. Researchers have evidence that the inhabitants were some of the first to transition from being hunter-gatherers to more settled farmers. The team found traces of more than 100 different plant species that either grew at the site or were collected from the wild, as well as animal remains, including those from domesticated animals. Sheep and pig bones may be evidence the residents raised and hunted animals for food. Fishing also seemed to play a big role in the society, with over 6,000 fish bones located during excavation. There is still more to learn about one of the earliest settlements found with evidence of domesticated cattle, including how it became submerged. An Italian study found that a volcanic collapse of Mount Etna 8,500 years ago may have caused a 131-foot-high tsunami that would have engulfed some of the Mediterranean coastal cities. But the fact that the megalithic stone circle still remains standing in the place it was constructed leads some researchers to disregard the idea that a tsunami wiped out the settlement. Some point to the fact that it could have been climate change that caused the glaciers to melt and sea levels to rise enough that it would have flooded the land slowly. Luckily, the unique conditions of clay and sandy sediment under saltwater are the perfect conditions to keep everything well preserved and allow researchers to explore this ancient site even more. And now for number 4. But first, want to give a big shout out to Javier Aguilar and Bronwyn Crocker. Thanks so much for watching and spending time with us. If you are new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button to join the Origins Explained family. Number 4. Doggerland. 20,000 years ago, the British Isles were connected to mainland Europe by a land bridge known as Doggerland. Is it just me or does Doggerland sound like a city from Mad Max? Now completely submerged, the landmass allowed early Mesolithic people to travel more easily. It was always assumed that a landslide decimated the area off the coast of Norway around 6150 BC. This triggered a tsunami in the North Sea that flooded the British coastline, which likely killed thousands of people who lived by the water. Originally believing the tsunami was the culprit for separating Britain from mainland Europe, new research published by archaeologists argues that Doggerland may have actually survived as an archipelago of islands. After 15 years of examining the underwater remains, researchers mapped the territory's marshes, rivers, and other geological features and took samples of underwater rock. By studying these underwater sediment cores, samples showed evidence of the flood which would have killed anyone on the shoreline when it struck 8,200 years ago. Even though the tsunamis would have killed many of the existing hunter-gatherers and fishing societies along the coast, researchers believe the landmass would have survived the cataclysmic event. Oil companies drilling in the North Sea use seismic survey data to construct a digital model of the 18,000 square miles of what Doggerland looked like before it was flooded. The wooded valley slowly disappeared over time, so the people who lived here thousands of years ago had to move to higher ground. Even today, fishermen continue to find ancient bones and tools, evidence of the people who lived here so long ago. If you think all of this is in the ancient past, think again. Climate scientists say that a similar situation could affect anyone who lives within 37 miles of shoreline today, especially if the polar ice caps continue to melt at an accelerated rate. Do you think we should be worried about a tsunami like this happening anytime soon? Let me know in the comments below. Number 3. Cenote Angelita. Located just 10.5 miles south of Tulum, Mexico, Cenote Angelita is a haven for scuba divers who want to explore the past. A series of sinkholes and caves in the jungle lead to the submerged cenote, a 200-foot-deep pool nestled into the dense surroundings. For those who can brave the depths, they can experience an unexpected surprise in the water-filled cave. Inside, under the water, there is a river that flows to the ocean. Wondering how this happens? It starts with the creation of the cenote itself. As limestone bedrock collapses, it sinks and forms a pit, which acts as a reservoir that fills with fresh groundwater and salt water. As organic matter like plants and vegetation decompose in the water, they create a layer of halocline, which is a cloud of hydrogen sulfide that separates the fresh water from the salt water below. This is what happened at Cenote Angelita, which is a marvel on its own. But to make this particular cenote stand out even more from the hundreds of others in the Yucatan, submerged trees within the underwater cave make it a truly magical underworld. The cenote was once a holy site worshipped by the ancient Maya, and you can see why. Anyone who dives here will fall straight into a blue underworld, and the deeper you go, the more trees you will see submerged in a wispy fog. The Maya must have thought the gods themselves lived down here. These unique elements of the water's chemistry allow the denser water to sink to the bottom and gives the optical illusion that an underground river flows through. Number 2. Croatian boat wreck. 3,200 years after it sank, a remarkable boat wreck was discovered off the coast of Croatia. Marine archaeologists in France found the unique Bronze Age boat in a cove in 2014. The sunken ship was first seen by fishermen in 2008, just 600 meters from the beach. However, they believed it to be a fairly recent wreck. Everyone kind of knew it was there, but ignored it. However, researchers from the Archaeological Museum of Istria believed the boat to be quite old and were intrigued. They decided to investigate the site, and the boat was determined to be from pre-Roman times. Stretching over 23 feet in length and 8 feet wide, the ship was just sleeping 6.5 feet below the surface of the water. Back in the day, shipbuilding was hard. The researchers found that these shipbuilders had used a technique of shipbuilding used in the Adriatic until the Roman era, when there were no metal fasteners available, or they were too expensive. Carefully shaped planks were sewn together with ropes, roots, or willow branches, and their sections overlapped so they didn't need any metal fasteners to bind them together. The boat is incredibly well preserved for how old it is, with most of its stitching still visible in areas and the frame largely undamaged. Multiple types of wood were used to build the boat, with experts conducting tree ring dating to determine the age, and revealed it was from around 1200 BC. Scientists hope to move it to a boat museum in Croatia so the world can marvel at the artistry. Number 1. Pavlo Petri. In 1904, a geologist reported discovering an ancient city in the seabed near Greece. It was the city of Pablo Petri, and in its heyday, some 4,000 years ago, it was once home to a bustling port. The area was famous for trade going back as far as the Bronze Age. Ceramics recovered confirmed that the site was once occupied by Mycenaeans as early as 3,500 BC. Instead of being based around a godlike figure or king, like many ancient cities, Pablo Petri seems to have emerged into greatness not just because of its relationship to the sea, but also because of its affinity for trade and economics. The ancient city was a sprawling network of stone buildings and two-story homes that even had plumbing. The city had a complex water management system involving gutters and canals. As archaeologists dove into the ancient city, they recovered shards of cooking pots and crockery, as well as storage vessels which were used to transport products like oil, wine, and perfumes, most likely kept to impress visitors of a higher status used to make offerings to the gods. Other items included obsidian blades and bronze figurines. Dense concentrations of these vessels in certain buildings suggest they were used as centralized storage and probably redistribution. An operation such as this would have required an advanced level of accounting and administration to keep track of everything coming in and out. Upon further exploration, researchers found the prehistoric town had intact building foundations and courtyards, as well as rock-cut tombs with graves. In 2009, an extensive underwater survey was done to map the structural remains. During the survey, 15 previously unknown buildings were discovered, including buildings and streets that date back to between 1680 and 1180 BC. It's clear that the people of Pablo Petri were in touch with all of the latest innovations. The city offers a rare opportunity to study in detail how an ancient port functioned, and even more importantly, the extent of seafaring contacts and trade in the Bronze Age. Thanks for watching! Who wants to go diving? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. See you soon! Bye!